It's hard to believe this building is right here on the campus. A theater like this, there's really no other one like it in the country. It's amazing to have it here for the use of not just the music school, but the entire university. It'll be a great asset to the city.
To walk in to this hall, the only thing you can say is, wow. I mean, it is beyond all of our expectations, our dreams. We know it's acoustically wonderful, but it is so beautiful, visually beautiful.
The soaring ceilings, the big windows, all the beautiful light streaming in. You just know that you're in a very special place.
Brockman Hall for Opera is just a magnificent facility. I just found it breathtaking, actually. And it's, of course, an incredible facility for the Shepherd School of Music, but this is going to be an unbelievable asset for the entire university.
The Brockman Music and Performing Arts Center is a building that is very much like an instrument in and of itself. It is something that has to be used in a certain kind of way to generate music, to make sound, and to engage with people. One of the advantages of building this building from the ground up, after years of study and analysis, figuring out exactly what it was that we would need, was being able to do it right the first time. It was designed from the inside out to be incredibly effective for young voices to be able to project out over a large symphony orchestra in the pit. So the intimacy of the hall, the way in which it's all put together, the fact that you can be upstage and still project a voice or project from a string quartet doing a chamber music performance, the acoustics are just extraordinary. I'm so proud of the fact that we've been able to actually find a way to put this building in place on the Rice University campus.
The Shepherd School was founded in the basement of Sewell Hall. And today, this is a nationally prominent music school from that humble beginning. Bob Yakovich's role here at Rice, and in particular for the Shepherd School of Music, is legendary. Basically took a wonderful music school and over the past 18 years has brought it to national prominence.
When I arrived in 2003, we developed a long-range plan for the opera program. And we arrived at the conclusion that the best thing to do was to build the quality of the program. And then someday, if we achieved that, it would become necessary to have a facility that was appropriate for that kind of program.
It's a manifestation of what Edgar Odell Lovett said at the founding of the university, that there should be, in his words, no upper limit. This is as big a statement of that in some ways as there can be.
One of the things that you first notice when you approach this building is the grand scale of the design. It stands out as a remarkable monument.
No other school has the rare combination of facilities and exemplary faculty and extraordinarily gifted students that the Shepherd School now has.
It was just an idea. There was no reason that Rice University should have the finest university conservatory in America.
We added two sizable rehearsal halls, one of which, the Dean's Rehearsal Hall, is designed and configured specifically on the dimensions of the Morrison Theaters.
So that students can actually do all of their staging, their blocking, and their rehearsing in a custom designed space that's exactly like the stage.
State-of-the-art sing shop with all of the bandwidth that's necessary to build large sets, dressing rooms, conductor suite, practice rooms for students. The Grand Foyer was designed to be a beautiful gathering space for people to congregate. We were fortunate to pick a team that, with Alan Greenberg, Thomas Noble Architects, Scott Pfeiffer and Robin Glossmeyer Patron Acousticians, and Josh Dax, and Matt Brogan as theater consultants. That team was extraordinary in their ability to collaborate with one another. All of that was greatly facilitated by my former associate dean, Gary Smith, and Marty Merritt, Mike Fries. Those three were absolutely pivotal to this, the realization of this project. Acoustics were the driving force from the very beginning.
We've got a pit that can hold up to 70 musicians, which means there's all kinds of significant repertoire that we'll be able to do.
Ranges of theater, musical theater, obviously opera, regular theater, as well as VIP speaker events, those kinds of things. And so it will be a wonderful venue for the city of Houston in that respect.
One of our priorities has really been to engage Rice with the city of Houston and Harris County. And that means both folks getting out into the community, but also making sure the community comes to Rice and experiences some of what we have to offer.
We really sort of built a core set of facilities that truly does draw outsiders into Rice in a way that sometimes is difficult.
Rice University was always meant to be open to the community, to everyone in Houston, and we see the Brockman Hall as an extension of that, as an opportunity to bring people in, get to know Rice, enjoy the campus, and particularly this beautiful building.
We're interested in having diverse voices come onto campus. We're very interested in making sure that what we're doing is relevant, that it matters, that it has impact in our immediate communities and also abroad.
The school typically mounts somewhere between 450 performances each year. It is a resource that has, I think, grown in importance. The Shepherd School has evolved to be really one of the major cultural resources of the city of Houston.
The philanthropic part of the Brockman Hall for Opera is different than any other project I've ever worked on. We must also recognize that this project would never have happened without David Lebron. David's love of the arts, of Rice, of the Shepherd School, he was a driving force behind this. There's no question.
To have grown so much in prestige and in being acknowledged as one of the best music schools in the country, it's been thrilling to watch that.
Well, I look forward to Dean Loden really building on the remarkable achievements of Bob Yakovich. This school is such a jewel in Rice's crown, and I think the luminance of that jewel is only going to grow.
It touches people's lives in a way that we may never know.
The Shepherd School of Music is and has been sort of the cultural center of Rice University.
President Lebron feels that the arts can and should be central to the Rice experience, both for Rice students and for the broader Houston community.
This was not just a Rice project. This is a city project. In fact, in a way, it's a national project.
The academic shield of Rice University, there are three words: letters, science, and art. The vision of Edgar Odell Lovett was, in fact, that art would be central. We believe that this building is, in fact, a realization of that vision.
Bob Yakovich has been a friend, a colleague, and frankly, a mentor for the last 20 years of my life. To be able to be in so many spaces that are the direct result of who and how Bob Yakovich actually moved to the world and what he accomplished it just feels really special.
Bob was widely recognized by his peers at Rice as being quietly ambitious. You know, when we needed a new violin professor, Bob would identify the very best candidate in the world and go after them. It really reflects Bob's ambition for the Shepherd School, his view of what greatness really is. It is no accident that the Shepherd School is one of the finest conservatories in the world. It is because we've had great, great leadership. Bob Yakovich deserves an awful lot of credit for having this school where it is today.
After nearly 2 years of delay, we're finally able to officially open the Brockman Music and Performing Arts Center. For me, this truly represents the collective achievement, not only of the Shepherd School of Music, but of the larger university and, in many ways, the city of Houston. I think the excellence of the Shepherd School of Music, its distinguished faculty, gifted students, dedicated staff, all of that was fundamental, really, to making the case for this effort. And then when you add to that the incredible fundraising campaign led by Ann Duncan and Susie Glasscock and underpinned by the transformative gifts of the A. Eugene Brockman Charitable Trust and Lucian and Nancy Morrison. And then a third and critical ingredient was the sustained support of David Liebrand and the entire board of Rice trustees. So ultimately, it took more than a village, and in some ways, a whole city to bring this project to fruition. So in consideration of that, I'd just like to take this opportunity to offer my deepest thanks to all of you. I know that many of you are in the audience tonight for your roles, both directly or indirectly, in making this dream a reality. It's something that I'm profoundly thankful for and will remain immensely proud of for the many years to come.